Het is zoveel pret om net in die water te springen en te kan baljaar. But we're talking about aging and the effects that it has on our body. Dr. Darren Green, thanks for joining us this morning. 083-913-3728 if you want to give us a call. We have Anonymous on the line from Boksburg. Anonymous, you live on Expresso. What's your question?
Good morning, Dr. Green. I want to know, why is my blood pressure always high? The top one, 180, 170. The bottom one is always 80. I'm 85 years old. In 3 months' time, I'll be 86. And I've got a thyroid problem, but I had blood count taken, a full blood count. Everything is 100%. But why am I getting more skinnier and skinnier? I have a gluten problem. I eat gluten-free food. That's my question.
Thank you so much, Anonymous, and congratulations on the birthday in 3 months' time. Thank you for your question.
86.
What do you want to say to Anonymous this morning?
She mentions two things. She mentions hypertension, and what she mentions is systolic hypertension. So the top value is your systolic blood pressure, 180, she says, over 80. That's uncontrolled. She should aim to try and get it at least under 140. Mm-hmm. So in old people, we find systolic hypertension being a realistic problem. Mm-hmm. And the reason for that is the arteries become harder and calcified, and the ability to stretch and adapt to the changes in the cardiovascular system are affected with age. The second part of the question is getting thin. Mm. And that involves, obviously, as you get older, often people get smaller. Mm. Their structure and frame actually looks like it shrinks, and that's due to the loss of architecture of the bones. But the muscles also, if they're not utilized properly and you're not doing weight training, for example, or exercising rigorously, you have atrophy, wasting of the muscles. So there are a lot of reasons for that. Firstly, due to pain and joint problems, people mobilize less, so they use the muscles less. So you use it or you lose it principle. So that's quite tough. So that's why we urge older people to keep moving to preserve the integrity and the tone of the muscles.
Quickly, doctor, there's still help for us. Just because we're growing older doesn't mean we don't need to maintain our health. What can you tell us quickly? How can we maintain our health?
Yeah, just summarizing it, I think eating well, so looking at high fiber foods to keep the bowel motion going, rehydrating enough, drinking enough fluids, exercise, keeping mobile, sleeping enough, and certainly if you have any chronic lifestyle conditions, take your medication and be compliant.
Ah, be compliant, he says, and he's talking about a whole lot of lifestyle changes. Dr. Darren Green, thanks for being here this morning.
Thank you.
Well, age is nothing but a number, they say. So, hey, whatever you do this morning, and thanks for all our callers that called us this morning, just stay healthy and keep eating well. Thanks, doctor, again, for joining us this morning. Oh, there's lots more happening on our Feel Good Breakfast Show. This is a Tuesday, and we're glad you're with us. Ewan, over to you.